So I used to be extremely into Pokemon cards. Really, from 2015 to 2018, I was pretty obsessed. I went to pre-release events, had like 20 binders for all the different sets, and would constantly be scanning eBay for a good deal. I used to make a lot of videos too, but as time went on, I just wasn't as into it anymore. I still really liked the cards, but I didn't want to feel like I had to make a video every time I opened a pack, you know? But even though I haven't been actively collecting cards for a long time, I've still been interested in it. People are still asking me to make card videos again, so this is for you, the card video. Why Pokemon cards are cool and why they absolutely terrify me. Might also open some up at some point in the video if you want to stick around for that. But first, a quick thank you to the sponsor of this video, Baiyi. So Baiyi is a service that I've actually used before, so I was pretty excited when they reached out to me. It's a proxy buying service you can use to get exclusive items all the way from Japan. If you order something from, say, Rakuten or Yahoo Japan, then Baiyi will be able to ship it out for you. And there's a lot of Pokemon stuff that doesn't get released outside of Japan, especially when it comes to cards. But you could use it to get plushies, blankets, or pretty much anything Pokemon related you could think of. I'm gonna be interested in the Pokemon stuff obviously, but they have quite a wide range of sites they cover, so you can get all kinds of stuff. And if you use my link in the description, you can get a first time order coupon of 2,000 yen. That's about $20, whoa. So again, huge thank you to Baiyi for sponsoring this video. So back when I first got into Pokemon cards, it was much more reasonable of a hobby. The first pack of cards I opened after getting back into it was a pack of Furious Fists from the X and Y series. Let's break it down. Furious Fists has 7 EXs, 7 full arts, and 2 secret rares. It's quite a bit, but especially if you're buying singles and trading, it's really not that hard to complete the set. But then we jump to Sun and Moon's Lost Thunder, which is really the last set I was still buying cards. Lost Thunder has 13 GXs, 7 Prism cards, 19 full arts, and 21 secret rares. Bear in mind, from a single booster box, which is by itself about £100 on release, might get one, maybe 2 full arts if you're lucky, possibly a secret rare. I like collecting things, but can you see why I felt a bit overwhelmed? I was curious as to what the cost of all the ultra rares combined would be, so this might help you visualize. Furious Fist totals to $147.69, which, if you're a kid, is quite a bit of money, but completing a set over time isn't that unrealistic of a goal. Now let's see how much Lost Thunder comes to. $1,275.07. That is terrifying. And that isn't even counting all of the common cards, rares, holos, and reverse holos in the set, which is gonna bring it up even more. To be fair, Lost Thunder is a really big set, but most sets these days will end up costing you high hundreds to complete. And that's if you buy the actual cards, let alone if you try to complete a set through just packs. And there are about 5 different sets a year! It got to the point where I couldn't justify spending that amount of money when I wasn't even making videos anymore. YouTube ad rev couldn't save my card addiction this time. Seriously though, and I say this as someone who's collected for years and still has a soft spot for the TCG, Pokemon cards are pretty much a soft form of gambling. Nowhere near as bad as something like a gacha game, but you still gotta be careful. You're gonna have that moment where you open a pack and you get an amazing card worth $100, but you're also gonna have moments where you buy one of those $50 collection boxes and get absolutely nothing. I could buy a game for $50 that could pay for my Adobe subscription this month. I still do find cards really cool, and I still have all of my binders and everything I've collected over the years, but I just wasn't investing the time so much anymore. It's a bit of a shame because pretty much right when I dipped out is when they started releasing a bunch of really cool stuff. I missed out on Cosmic Eclipse and the 2 sets that just literally have dozens of shiny cards in them, or the tag team cards. You know, Team Up is only 2 years old. I can probably get a booster box for a good price.
What?
Feel like I've skipped a few chapters. Why are all of these recent sets so astronomically expensive? I was very confused, so I enlisted the help of my good TCG-obsessed friend Toby from Birdkeeper Toby. So basically, in the last year, the entire Pokemon card market has gone pretty insane. Toby described it to me as sort of the perfect storm of factors. Pokemon haven't been able to print and distribute sets in as high quantities as normal for the last year because of COVID, and with there being quite a few high interest sets anyway in the past couple of years, demand was already pretty high. And then you had people like Logan Paul driving up interest in base set, which introduced a lot of people outside of the community to the market, making them realize, Pokemon cards are actually worth quite a bit of money. Let's scalp everything. And somehow we end up in this nightmare scenario where some of the old stuff has gone up 5 times in value in the space of a few months. Where fans can't even get their hands on new stuff because resellers are scalping, cleaning out the shelves, and sticking new stuff on eBay for double the price. Even just recently, I hear it's so bad that Target and Walmart, basically the biggest in-person retailers for cards in the US, are now refusing to even sell anything at all because people can't behave themselves. I've always thought of Pokemon cards as a pretty good investment. If you buy something sealed at retail price, it's pretty much never going to go below that retail price. And it absolutely will go up over time. And there's always going to be a market for it because it's Pokemon.
Pokemon collectors are scary, I would know.
They're not like other collectibles like figures where people know to keep them sealed. People still buy old stuff to open because some of the cards themselves are sought after. So once a set goes out of print, the supply is only going to go down as time goes on. It's just that a lot of people recognize the potential value in this at the same time, and now it's at the expense of regular fans that just want to collect cool cards and play the game. My own sealed collection is modest at best. I was never really that interested in sealed products, but since I was so into cards in general, I kind of accumulated a few bits here and there. Like this generation's elite trainer box! I bought this in 2016 or 2017 for about £50. I was tempted to open it, but I thought, nah, maybe if I stash it away for 10 years it'll go up a bit. There's definitely this weird value on sealed stuff. With the older sets, so at this point, Gen 5 and below, there are quite a few sets where a single pack is more valuable than any card you could pull from it, with the exception of some PSA 10s or something. But your average collector isn't gonna care about that, they just want the card. Like, look at this. Emerging Powers booster box, going for about £1,500 on eBay. Emerging Powers, complete set, £150. Is there something I'm not getting here? I thought the whole value of old packs is in the potential of the cards inside? What? It makes me wince quite a bit thinking back on just how much old stuff I used to open. I wasn't buying base set boosters or anything, but I was still buying pretty old packs to open up on the channel. But it was all super cheap back then. Pretty much all of the packs I bought fell somewhere in the $4 to $20 range, usually on the lower end. I went back through some of my old orders, you're gonna love these. In 2016, I bought a Call of Legends booster for £2.88. Now goes for anywhere between £120 to £250. A couple of Japanese jungle boosters for £5.10 each, now worth about £150. A couple of Japanese Neo Genesis packs for £5.10 each, now go for anywhere between £150 to £250. It's painful to think about how much it'd all be worth in a world where I just kept everything I ever bought sealed, but, you know, value went up a lot more slowly back then. How was I meant to predict a global pandemic and Logan Paul? I think it's cool that I even got to open up any of that stuff in the first place because I'm probably never gonna get to do it again. I mean, I could, but somehow paying £200 to open a pack of cards I paid less than £3 for in 2016 doesn't feel like something I should do as a responsible adult. So in conclusion, Pokemon cards are terrifying, and that's why I haven't bought any for about 3 years. On an unrelated note, I bought Pokemon cards. Look, when I was writing the script, there happened to be a big restock of one of the sets with all the shinies in it, so I caved and got a couple boxes to open. People have been hounding me to make card videos again, so this is it. Here you go. Let's see how much money I lose. Let's go. Here we go. Elite Trainer box. I don't have a fancy background or anything, but I thought you might want to look at this Torchic I got from McDonald's. It doesn't have any eyes. Here we go. Fancy sleeves. Ooh, it's got a pretty nice promo. Is that friggin' textured? What the heck? And we get, I believe, 10 packs of Shining Face. Let's be real, probably not making my money back on this unless I get a ton of hits. Or if I get like the Charizard or the Suicune. All right, let's do this. Pack number one. More Pekko. Okay, so I think the shinies take the place of the reverse, so that means no shiny for us. We got a holo. Galarian Weezing, oh that's nice. Ain't gonna pay for the box, but it's pretty neat. All right, Weasel. Got Shinx. Oh, what? Oh, I swear. Yeah. Okay, that's pretty neat. Yeah, look at that. That's one of the VMAXs. I like him. Look at that. With some luck, might not lose money on this box. I might not. Let's see. More Pekko. Got a reverse of a Manaphy. That's a rare we got.
in the last pack. That's pretty cool. And we got Indeedee, another holo. Okay. Neat. Luxio, Gossifleur, Snom, Koffing, Cacnea, Gossifleur. Did I get like two Gossiflers in the same pack, or am I just like, what the heck? I've never had that happen before, like two Pokemon in the same pack. Is that an error or what? Then we got the Wacky is the reverse, and then Volcanion. Got a reverse Ball Guy and Yanmega. Cufant, reverse Snom, and we got, yo, what the, oh, cool, oh, full art. Gym trainer, neat. I'm gonna put him down there. Great, got more Peko. We got one. Which one's this? It's Galarian Meowth. Yo, cool. And from the actual thing we got Dreadnought. That is my first shiny vault. And these are actually textured as well. Not gonna lie, probably one of my least favorite ones in the set, but you know, we good, it's fine. Weasel. Beauty. Love him. All right, we got Trapinch. We got a reverse of Floatzel. And the rare, yo, oh, Cramorant VMAX, neat. We got two full arts and one, but I guess like technically three. Yo, nice guy. We got two more packs left. I'm feeling good. The reverse is an Eevee. Quite fitting, and there's something behind this Eevee, I swear. We got an upside down Delmise V. Look at that. This is the final pack. I just wanted the baby shiny, man. More Peko, Cacnea. Oh, oh, whoa. I wanna say this is the second most valuable baby shiny, so like we've got really lucky with this box. Oh my goodness. And the final is another Galarian Weezing. This box is freaking nuts, man. What the heck? I got three holos. From the regular set, I got one V card, one full art, and one VMAX full art, which is pretty nuts, if I may say. And from the shiny vault, I got Galarian Rapidash, Galarian Meowth, and Ditto VMAX. 6 hits out of 10 packs, and then 3 holos. Like, what? So between all of these hits, I'm actually pretty sure that we broke even on the box. Maybe even made a little profit? Kind of messes with the whole narrative I was trying to construct with this video, which was you usually lose money with Pokemon cards. So I'm gonna open up another one. I need to prove a point. I'm gonna lose money on this. Same deal, 10 packs, let's lose some money. Yeah. Ooh, hey, yo, Runericus, look at that. That is pretty cool. Thing. Zarude reverse. And then we got Volcanion. Spinarak. Yo! Oh! Well, that's a hit. That's the first amazing rare we've got. Pretty nice. And then we got Indeedee V. Yeah, so we've got 3 hits already. It's really cool though. Like him. I really like that amazing rare though. Luxio and Professor's Research Rare. Oh, I forgot they started making trainer rares again. Yo, oh, that's cute. Oh, I like that. I like that a lot. Okay, and we got another Indeedee holo. That is probably not worth very much at all, but I really like him. Team Yowtow and Dreadnought. Thwacky. And we got another Yanmega. Hey. Cramorant reverse and another Zarude. Yeah, that's like 3 packs in a row. What's going on? Weasel. Shinx. What? Yo! Oh, that is cool. Look at that. That's the hit we were waiting for. Oh my god, the Decidueye. Nice. Cacnea. The final shining vault is, oh, it's a shiny. Cufant. Neat. Wow, we got really lucky with the baby shinies. The final rare is, it's another Professor's Research. So we actually got more hits from the shiny vault this time, but I'm still pretty sure that we lost money on this box, so I guess I win, right? In conclusion, boxes are very fun to open, but if you want to get a particular card, just buy singles. Now to never open Pokemon cards ever again.
Hey, thanks for watching. It was a card video, so now you don't have to ask me to do that anymore. Thanks so much for the fan art as always. It really means a lot to me. And I will see you whenever my next video is. Bye!
The dark side of Pokemon TCG no one tells you about.